One in 10 school-aged children in the U.S. can experience symptoms like tightness in the chest, shortness of breath, coughing, and wheezing. And the condition that brings on these frightening symptoms is asthma. And asthma is one of the most common non-communicable diseases among children worldwide. We know that asthma can be caused by outdoor air pollution and also to exposure indoors to chemicals, strong odors, mold, and smoke. There is no cure for asthma, but the disease can be managed by avoiding indoor triggers, which are known as asthmogens. Asthmogens commonly found in household products and home materials include formaldehyde, which can be found in furniture glues, glycol ethers that are in paints and finishes, quaternary ammonia compounds, or quats, which you can find in disinfectants, and phthalates that you might find in plastics, paints, or your cleaning products. Fragrance chemicals in scented products, including sprays, can trigger asthma attacks and respiratory difficulties. The benefits of avoiding asthmogens begin actually before birth. A study published in 2020 by the Canadian Medical Association Journal followed infants from the beginning of gestation to 3 years old. The study reviewed how frequently their households used 26 cleaning products during the infant's first 3 or 4 months. The list of products included dish and laundry detergents and multi-surface and glass cleaners. For the study, this data was compared to their health outcomes at age 3. They found that almost 19% of children in households with high use of cleaning products often wheezed or had asthma. The risk was higher in those households that frequently used air fresheners, deodorizers, dusting sprays, antimicrobial hand sanitizers, and oven cleaners, along with scented spray cleaning products. On the other hand, chronic wheezing and asthma were actually lower in households with lower cleaning product use. The study's authors theorized that damage to airway linings from frequent exposure to these products may be what's triggering the anti-inflammatory responses of the immune system and thereby leading to asthma. So the risk of developing asthma can extend beyond childhood. A 10-country study of more than 3,500 individuals who were initially free of asthma found that 9 years later, those who used spray cleaners at least once a week to clean their homes had a 30 to 50% increased risk of developing asthma during the study period. This association was linked primarily to commonly used spray products such as air fresheners, glass cleaners, and furniture cleaning sprays. The risk increased the more often people use sprays or the greater the number of different sprays they used. So what can we do to decrease the risk and the effects of asthma? The Environmental Working Group recommends limiting household cleaning products and avoiding the use of spray cleaners and products with the word fragrance on the label. Also recommended, opening windows and doors for ventilation during and after cleaning. And one more thing, when possible, remove children from rooms being cleaned and, of course, safely lock up cleaning supplies. Now, I don't know about you, but I think that anytime it's advisable to remove children and safely lock up cleaning supplies, you gotta ask, why not stop using those harmful chemicals entirely, especially when there are safe and effective alternatives? Wheezing and other symptoms of asthma aren't any fun to experience, and it's time to radically reduce the use of harmful chemicals in homes so everyone can breathe easier.